So let's do an Online Divisions gameplay with Flamengo. It's been a while since I've played with Flamengo. Obviously, it's out of season in Brazil, so we won't have a form advantage or anything like that. They will be in neutral form, but I want to try out some tactics and I want to try it out in online competitive games. So we're going to play a season in Online Division 6. So let's start by just taking a quick look at the tactics I'm going to use. So I'm going to play with two different tactics, or let me correct myself. I'm going to play with one tactic, but it's going to be two different formations. The instructions will be basically the same for both. And the first one is this 4-4-2 formation, which I covered in a video, the tactical video. And the preferred starting lineup is going to be like this. Obviously, we're going to rotate a lot because the team is not in form. So we will have lots of games where players are out of form and I have to rotate. And this will be our primary tactic whenever we don't face a player with three strikers. And then we have this setup, which is a 3-4-3, which we will use in games against players with three strikers. For example, a 4-3-3 or a 3-4-3 or whatever combination with three forwards. So this is basically the attacking formation that Jorge Jesus was using back when he was the Flamengo manager. The 4-4-2 was basically his defending formation, and this one, the 3-4-3, was his attacking formation. Let's jump into Online Divisions and start playing some games. So I forgot that I was in the middle of a Valencia Online Divisions. I'm going to finish this season using Flamengo, so it's going to be like a short 5-game season. So Flamengo award 481. Okay, so the first opponent is Bayern München, and he's playing 60 up the middle and then balanced on the wings. And he is playing with wingers here, so I'm gonna go with the 4-4-2. And I feel like we're really lucky we only have one player out of form for this one, and it's Bruno. So I'm gonna put Gabriel Barbosa as the second striker. And I was planning on starting Pedro, I didn't see he was on orange. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to use Vitinho as the second striker, and we have Barbosa up front. And for this one, we are man-marking. I think we're going to put Rodrigo Caio on Lewandowski, and then Leo Pereira on Thomas Müller. And then we're going to have Isla on Sané and Felipe Luis on Gnabry. And we are also man-marking the central midfielders like this. Just to try it out, you know, Jorge Jesus was doing man-marking in defense, so that's what we're gonna do. I love playing at the Maracanã. You have this opening shot and you have this home chance and everything. Let's see if we can get a good start against this guy. We're just gonna play patiently, try to build and go around on the wings. Look at the space for Sané here. No! So obviously he catches us on the counter and Isla does not get back in time. Ooh. Oh! Was a little bit stressed there because you don't have a lot of time when you have the ball. Outside the box against Bayern. There he comes again. We are struggling so much with their wingers. No. That's a really nice play by him. We have no chance when they come on the counter. Our players have no idea what's going on, especially the wingers. we're lucky to get that chance, and we capitalize on it. Just have to try to build patiently, because we are not playing counter-attacking, we're playing possession, and we want to build on the wings. There we go. It's so important to find like the tight line between inviting press and being pressed out of possession, because you need to invite the press to be able to open up space, but it's so easy to lose the ball as well. It's a fine balance, right, between those two. Everton Ribeiro. No! Okay, so we managed to claw back. We're tied at 2. We're still in the game. No, no, come on! Oh! Uh-oh. No! I had much more time than I thought there. I was just a little bit stressed. I could have just taken the ball down and done a lot of stuff. Could have dribbled, fake shot feint. Should have scored. Oh, imagine if he would have hit that. And it ends in a draw. After the start, being 2 goals down, I definitely thought we were gonna lose, but we actually had a decent chance to win this. And we have a lot of possession, we play simple, we try to play patiently. We definitely could have won this, but I'm encouraged. By the result, I think we play well. The formation is definitely working. So let's jump ahead. Let's take a look at the table first. So we are now at 13-38. And we still have to win a couple of more games to secure the spot. And hopefully I will face another team than Bayern München. As you can see, I've faced Bayern in 4 of the final 5 games here. So let's jump ahead there. So this is going to be a real challenge. Manchester United is probably the hardest team to play against in terms of press. They are so good and so quick all over the pitch. And this guy is playing 68 up the middle and then a little bit more on the left. And he is going with 3 strikers. So I will use my 3 defenders formation for this one. And we actually have everyone ready to go, and we have Pedro on the bench in good form, also Diego in good form, and Gustavo Henrique. Actually, I'm gonna start Gustavo Henrique instead of William Arau, like this, and then once again we're gonna man mark. I think their attackers are way quicker than my defenders, so let's hope it won't be a problem. So he's going on 1 red immediately here. That's a nice move by him. I was just expecting my player to intercept the ball there, but he held him off and he scored. I mean, it sucks to concede goals, but if it's a well-played goal, I don't mind all that much. But what you will notice here, he's on 1 red, obviously, so he's gonna press like crazy. He's doing some insane press here. I'm really struggling to get anything going. Look at this, I have no chance, guys. I have no chance at playing out because he's covering, he's man marking. Oh. This guy is really good. I have to say it immediately. This guy really knows what he's doing. He might be the best player I've faced in a while, in a good while, including all these Bayern guys. I mean, if you play with Bayern, you get a lot of for free, obviously, because the team is so good. But I mean, Manchester United is good, but not that good. If you play this good with Manchester United, you are actually pretty good. It's a nice goal, but you know, 45th minute defending, the central defenders just are AWOL. That's one thing you have to learn when you play this game. When it closes in on halftime, just get the ball way out of there, because your defense is not gonna defend for you. So we have little chance in this. I don't think we will mount a comeback. We have no chance. This guy's tactical setup, and especially he got the third goal. I mean, at 2-0, we could have perhaps had a chance if we got like the next goal, but he's so advanced, like tactically, that he's actually playing manual offside traps, which is pretty impressive, I must say. Something that pisses me off the most are that, like, the calculated bounces of interception attempts. Because you just know it's not gonna fall to you. You do so much to intercept it, and you should have the ball. There's no reason why the player can't control the ball. But the game just decides, nope, it's gonna bounce way off and you're not gonna get it. So we lose the game. They were so good in the start of the game, and after a while, when we got like the consolation goal, the momentum tipped a little bit in our favor. And I mean, if we would have gotten like one or two like passes at the end there on almost opportunities, we could have gotten a point here. But in the end, I think it was an okay result considering the opponent. Really good opponent, really good player, and a really good team. And we still have 3 games to try to get the points we need. So let's just skip ahead here to the next game. Okay, so for this one we face Arsenal, and the Gunners are playing 60 up the middle and then a little bit more on the right. And for this one, since he's only playing like a single striker in the center, I'm gonna go with the 4-4-2. And we have to make a couple of changes. First of all, René is gonna start at left back. And then Gerson is out. And I think I will start Diego in this one. And for the man marking, I'm gonna put Caio on Auba. And then I'm gonna put William Arao on William, and Maurizio Isla is gonna try to take Martinelli, and then we have René on Pepe. So it's tied at the break, and I think this could go either way. We just have to get the first goal. There's lots of space to attacking, like, both ways. So we have to be careful on counters against us, and we have to try to be a little bit more patient when attacking. Come on. Yes, Bruno. He was so open there. If I hadn't scored there after the huge chance right before, I would have been pissed. I can't believe... Sometimes I don't understand, like, the passing. How Diego, who has so good passing skills, can hit that so badly. Barbosa. Okay, so he disconnects and we pick up the win we needed. Let's see how many points we need, if a simple draw will be enough or if we need to win one more game to stay. And I think perhaps a draw can be enough. I'm not sure though, but we're gonna go for the win, obviously, but we have two games remaining. Okay, so we are back to facing Bayern. And he's playing 56 up the middle and then a lot more on the left than on the right. And he's playing with more or less three strikers. So I will go with the three defender formation for this one. And we have Barbosa is out for this one, but we have Pedro on green. I mean, Pedro is a really good striker. He can score a lot of goals. He's a typical, like, goal poacher inside the box. And we actually have a lot of players in form, so perhaps we have a decent chance. Obviously, this guy is rated almost 800, so I expect a really tough game. And then we will do some man marking here. He actually has, like, more or less four attackers if we count in Müller. I'm gonna do a little bit of an adjustment like this, so we can use Gerson to man mark Müller, like this. So let's hope we can take advantage of his lack of depth, because he's playing with everyone in the middle. I mean, Alphonso Davies for this game, he is so quick. He's intercepting, like, everything. And I have no idea what's going on there. Leon Goretzka has all the time in the world. I mean, I've seen Alphonso Davies' defensive stats, and he's not good defensively. Like, really? Someone, how can no one take the ball? The ball is loose in front of two guys. So we're down at the break, but I definitely feel like there are some chances here, but it definitely will be a struggle because it's Bayern and they feel, as usual, so much quicker. I mean, when did Leon Goretzka turn into like prime Paul Pogba? That is so crazy. How good he is in this game. No way Leon Goretzka is that good in real life. I actually feel like the more pissed I get, the better I play. No. So he's on full red, so we are gonna get a lot of chances on counters here. We just have to score the next goal. Because if he scores another one, obviously, he's back in the game. Just have to keep calm and try to capitalize. No, what is going on with the defense? Oh man, no. Jesus, what a save. Oh man, look at this. And we hang on for the win. That was insane. I mean, this was a solid win because this guy was rated almost 800. He could easily have gotten like both the equalizer and the winner at the end there, but we hang on, we get the win, and that secures our spot. So what do you think about these Flamengo tactics? Obviously, you can set up this team in a bunch of different ways and make it work because they have so good players. So I want to thank you so much for watching. If you have any ideas for teams to test out, just let me know in the comments, and I will see you in the next one.